Psychiatrists warned they believe that President Trump's mental state presents a clear and present danger to our nation. Today, one of the psychiatrists says she said this about the president, quote, as he is unraveling, he seems to be losing his grip on reality and reverting to conspiracy theories. There are signs that he is going into attack mode when he is under stress. That means he has the potential to become impulsive and very volatile. Another expert who also briefed members of Congress is here with me tonight, Dr. James Gilligan. He's a psychiatrist and adjunct professor of law at New York University. Professor, thanks for joining me. Anytime a psychiatrist analyzes somebody who they've never actually examined, they're going to be accused of crossing a line. How do you respond?
Well, very simply, that I'm not interested in providing a diagnosis for President Trump. Because how can I put it? Mental illness doesn't equate with dangerousness. Most people who are mentally ill are not dangerous, and most of the people in our society who are dangerous are not mentally ill, as the law and psychiatry define it. What I'm concerned about is his dangerousness. I think the president we have now is unprecedentedly dangerous, more than any president in our history. And I mean dangerous both to our country and to the world. Whether this is because of his mental illness or not is beside the point. That's irrelevant. The question is not whether he's mentally ill. It is whether he is dangerous. And we have abundant evidence of his extreme and unprecedented dangerousness.
His supporters would say that he is unconventional and maybe he has some eccentricities, but they would take issue with you're saying he has a mental illness. Today, the White House called it disgraceful and laughable to suggest he's mentally unfit. What's your response to that?
I'm not saying he has a mental illness. I'm not saying he does not have a mental illness. I'm simply expressing no opinion on that subject because that is irrelevant. People can be mentally ill without being dangerous, and they can be dangerous without being mentally ill. What I'm saying is he is dangerous. For example, he has incited his followers to commit assault and battery to anti-Trump protesters in political rallies, which they have done. Some of them have been tried for assault and battery. Then his only complaint was they weren't violent enough. So by the time of Charlottesville, one of them actually committed a murder. That is how Trump incites his followers. He's also boasted about his own sexual violence against women, sexual assaults, mm-hmm. Which is indicated he has committed repeatedly, ritually, without any sense of guilt or remorse. Instead of feeling guilty about it, he's proud of it and bragged about it.
Okay.
In other words, I could go, there is a list as long as my arm of evidence of his dangerousness.
We have to leave it there.